Good morning everyone. Today's lecture we will study oxidation and reduction reactions of aldehydes and ketones. We know that this oxidation and reduction reaction both are different to each other. That means in oxidation reaction addition of oxygen and in reduction reaction addition of hydrogen. These both oxidation and reduction reaction used to preparation of different types of product with aldehydes and ketones. Now we will study first oxidation reactions of aldehydes and ketones. These aldehydes, for example, are COOH. These aldehydes are oxidizing to corresponding carboxylic acids. Here, these aldehydes are oxidizing to corresponding carboxylic acid by using oxidants like that dilute HNO3, potassium permanganate and potassium or sodium dichromate. These three are oxidant and it is used as oxidizing agent in this reaction. Now see here with some examples. RCOH, it is an aldehyde. This aldehyde react with suppose oxidizing agent KNO4 in presence of dilute H2SO4. Here formation of RCOOH acid. This aldehyde, it is oxidized into acid. That means here addition of oxygen to this carbonyl carbon. Now we take some example of this reaction. Suppose we take CH3COOH. It is an acetaldehyde. This acetaldehyde react with oxidizing agent like potassium permanganate in presence of dilute H2SO4. This acetaldehyde is oxidizing into corresponding carboxylic acid, that is CH3COOH. It is called as acetic acid. It is a one reaction of aldehyde and ketone, that is oxidation of aldehydes to formation of corresponding carboxylic acid. We know that this oxidation reaction, it is easily occur when hydrogen atom, it is directly attached to this carbonyl group. This hydrogen, it is responsible for formation of oxidation reaction. In case of ketones like that formula RCOR. In case of ketones, hydrogen, it is not directly attached to carbonyl carbon. That means this ketone reaches oxidation reaction. Means this ketones, it is not possible or it is difficult to oxidation into corresponding carboxylic acid. But these ketones are oxidized by using strong oxidizing agent like that CrO3, hot concentrated HNO3 or dilute KMnO4. These three reagents are used oxidation of ketone into corresponding carboxylic acid. We see first example of this reaction. Suppose this is a RCOR. This ketone react with CrO3. Here this ketones, it is converted into corresponding carboxylic acid, but here formation of mixture of carboxylic acid with contain less number of carbon atoms than starting ketones. For example, suppose we take here RCOR, it is a mixed ketones. This mixed ketone react with oxidizing agent. Here formation of RCOOH plus aldehyde COOH. Here formation of mixture of carboxylic acid, and this mixture of carboxylic acid which contain one carbon atom less than corresponding starting ketones. Here two carbon atom, here also two carbon atom, but in starting ketone here three carbon atoms. Now in this reaction, this formation of carboxylic acid, it takes place breaking of this carbon-carbon bond. We see example of this reaction. Suppose we take CH CH3COOH. That means by using simple methods, oxidation with oxidizing agent, here formation of similar mixture of carboxylic acid. In this reaction, this ketone, it is oxidized into strong oxidizing agent, but here breaking of this carbon single bond carbon to formation of this mixture of carboxylic acid. Now we take second example of mixed ketones, that means unsymmetrical ketones. We will take here CH3CO C2H5, it is an ethyl methyl ketone. This mixed ketone react with oxidizing agent. Here also breaking of this carbon carbon single bond and formation of mixture of carboxylic acid. Now we see first, right? CH3COOH plus breaking of this carbon carbon bond, here formation of second carboxylic acid, that means C2H5COOH. Here formation of first molecule of carboxylic acid, it is a ethanoic acid, and second it is a propanoic acid with one carbon atom less than this starting ketones. It is an oxidation reaction of aldehyde and ketone. Both aldehyde and ketone oxidize into corresponding carboxylic acid by using oxidizing agent. But this oxidation reaction easily occur in aldehyde because this hydrogen, it is directly attached to carbonyl carbon, and in ketone, this ketone, it is oxidized into corresponding carboxylic acid by breaking of carbon single bond carbon and using strong oxidizing agents to formation of here mixture of carboxylic acid. And this mixture of carboxylic acid, it is a less number of carbon atom than this starting ketones. Then now we see reduction reactions of aldehyde and ketones. We know that reduction reaction means addition of hydrogen, and in this reaction this hydrogen adding to aldehyde and ketone to formation of corresponding hydrocarbons. That means in reduction reaction, addition of hydrogen to aldehyde and ketone, here formation of hydrocarbons. In reduction reaction of aldehyde and ketone, two reduction reactions are used. That means first Clemmensen's reduction reaction and second Wolff-Ischner reduction reaction. In both reduction reactions, this carbonyl group of aldehyde and ketone, it is reduced into methylene group. This carbonyl group in aldehyde and ketone, it is reduced into methylene group. It is a methylene group. That means here also we see this oxygen atom, one oxygen atom, it is replaced by two hydrogen atoms. In this reduction reaction of aldehyde and ketone, this carbonyl group, it is reduced into methylene group, and here also this oxygen atom, one oxygen atom in aldehyde and ketone, in both reduction reaction, it is replaced by two hydrogen atoms. Now we see first Clemmensen's reduction reactions of aldehyde and ketone. This Clemmensen's reduction reaction, here used a reducing agent as a zinc amalgam with concentrated hydrochloric acid. In first reaction, Clemmensen's reduction reaction, here using zinc amalgam with concentrated hydrochloric acid as a reducing agent. And this reducing agent, it is used to reduce aldehyde into corresponding hydrocarbons. We take some example. Suppose this is a carbonyl group. This carbonyl group in either aldehyde and ketone, it reacts with 4 methyl hydrogen in presence of reducing agent zinc amalgam with concentrated HCl. Here, this one oxygen is replaced into 2 hydrogen atoms. That means here formation of CH2 plus evolution of water molecule. Here, out of 4 methyl hydrogen, 2 methyl hydrogen reduction reaction. Now we see second reduction reaction, Wolff-Kishner reduction reaction. In Wolff-Kishner reduction reaction, by using reducing agent like that, we take second Wolff-Kishner reduction reaction, and in Wolff-Kishner reduction reaction, by using reducing agent as a hydrazine, that is NH2NH2. This is a hydrazine, it is used to reducing agent in Wolff-Kishner reaction, and in this reaction, this aldehyde ketone heating with potassium hydroxide in highly boiling solvent like that, ethylene glycol. Ethylene glycol, that means in this Wolff-Kishner reduction, the reducing agent used as a hydrazine in potassium hydroxide by using highly boiling solvent ethylene glycol. Now we take some example of this reaction. Suppose this is a carbonyl-carbonyl aldehyde ketone, and this carbonyl carbon firstly react with hydrazine. It is a hydrazine. We know that this reaction is also studied in aldehyde ketone react with ammonia derivative. That means this carbonyl group react with hydrogen. Here formation of hydrazone with carbon double bond nitrogen form. That means these two hydrogen react with oxygen. Here removal of water, nitrogen added to carbonyl carbon. Here formation of first carbon double bond nitrogen NH2. Here formation of hydrazone, and this hydrazone heating with potassium hydroxide in highly boiling solvent, that is ethylene glycol, to formation of corresponding hydrocarbon with N2 molecule. We see here this hydrazone heating with KOH in ethylene glycol. Here formation of CH2 plus N2 molecule. Here breaking of this carbon nitrogen double bond. Here formation of CH2 plus N2 molecule. Now we take some example of this reaction. We take suppose aldehyde CH3 CH2 COH. It is a propanol. This propanol firstly react with hydrazine NH2NH2. Here formation of CH3CH2C double bond NH2. That is CH3CH2C double bond NH2. And this hydrazone heating with potassium hydroxide in ethylene glycol. Here formation of CH3CH2CH3 plus removal of N2 molecule. Here this hydrazone presents of 3 carbon atom, and this nitrogen is attached to 3rd carbon, means breaking of this carbon double bond nitrogen. Here formation of CH3CH2CH3 plus removal of this N2 molecule. Here formation of propane. Suppose we take here CH3CO C2H5. It is a Butoone. This Butoone react with hydrazine. Here formation of carbon double bond nitrogen compound NH2, and here C2H5, and this hydrazone heating with potassium hydroxide in ethylene glycol. Here this carbon nitrogen double bond break in formation of alkane plus N2 molecule. That is here CH3CH2C2H5 plus N2 molecule. Here formation of butane as a alkane. Now we take next example of aromatic ketones. That means we write C6H5 COC2H5. heating in presence of KOH in ethylene glycol. This carbon double bond nitrogen break and formation of hydrocarbon plus N2 molecule. Who write here structure? C6H5O. This carbon double bond nitrogen break and this carbon it carry 2 hydrogen atom. And here C2H5 plus removal of N2. It is called as N-propyl benzene. By reaching aromatic ketones, here formation of straight chain alkyl substituted benzene. This Wood-Fischner reduction reaction is used to preparation of straight chain alkyl substituted benzene. It is not possible in Friedel-Crafts alkylation reactions. It is a second reduction reaction of aldehyde and ketone, which is known as Wood-Fischner reduction reaction. This is a two reduction reaction used aldehyde and ketone, Clemmensens reduction and Wood-Fischner reduction reaction, and in both reduction reaction carbonyl group is reduced into CH2 group. That means oxygen atom it is replaced by 2 hydrogen atom. Now we see next point, that is electrophilic substitution reactions of aldehydes and ketones. Aromatic aldehydes and ketones undergo carry electrophilic substitution reaction, that means electrophile incoming positively electrophile act into benzene ring in aromatic aldehydes and ketones. For we write here some example, suppose it is a COH, this is a benzyl grade, and second example we write here C6H5O, COCH3 is a methyl phenyl ketone. This both examples it is a aromatic aldehydes and ketones, and this aromatic aldehydes and ketone undergo electrophilic substitution reaction. In aromatic aldehydes and ketone, this aldehyde and this carbonyl group, it is an electron withdrawing group. This aldehyde and carbonyl group, it is an electron withdrawing group, and it have negative inductive effect. It have negative inductive effect. That means this carbonyl group, this aldehyde and carbonyl group, it is a resonance to this benzene ring. Therefore, this aldehyde and ketone group, it deactivate ortho and para position. Here, this aldehyde and ketone group, it carries negative inductive effect, or it is an electron withdrawing group. Therefore, it is an inductive effect and resonance by this benzene ring. Therefore, this aldehyde and ketone group, it deactivate ortho and para position. That means incoming electrophile is not attack on ortho and para position. Therefore, in this reaction, this incoming electrophile always at meta position. Always at meta position of this corresponding aldehyde and ketone group. Means this electrophilic substitution reaction in aromatic aldehyde and ketone, electrophile always at meta position to corresponding aldehyde and ketone position. We write example. Suppose we take here COH, this benzyl lake react with nitrating mixture. That means this benzyl lake react with concentrated HNO3 and concentrated H2SO4. In this nitrating mixture, here formation of NO2 plus as an electrophile, and this electrophile is a meta formation of this benzaldehyde. That means here formation of nitrobenzaldehyde. This reaction is called as nitration reaction. Addition of NO2 group to this aldehydic compound, it is known as nitration reaction. This aldehyde, this aromatic aldehyde and ketone, it is also undergo different electrophilic substitution reaction. That means halogenation reaction, sulfonation reaction to formation of meta product. It is a electrophilic substitution reaction. Here remember, this electrophilic substitution reaction always at meta position of aromatic.